we have a guest with us.
Come on, bro. Bring that chair. This is, by the way, this is Brother Omar Hamza Jenvy, Jenvy, isn't it? Yeah, Omar Hamza Jenvy. If you previously knew, his previous name was Glen Jenvy. And I'm sure if you, most of the people here, if you knew who he was and what his job was, wipe those frowns off your faces. But that was him, basically. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes the hearts of the people. I'm sure many people don't know. Do you want me to?
You can explain.
Okay. He used to be working for the so-called Secret Service, and he used to try to infiltrate Muslims around the world and so on, and he would pass information. There are many Muslims behind bars. But rather, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided the brother. The brother started thinking about Islam. And we know, my dear brothers and sisters, that this is not the first time that something like this has happened. We know the Sahaba, Amr ibn al-As, and I spoke about this last week, Amr ibn al-As, one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was crying on his deathbed. He was crying on his deathbed, and his son came up to him and said, "Oh my father, I saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam many times give you the glad tidings of Jannah. Many, many times the Prophet alayhi salam, he said, oh Amr, you are in Jannah. Why is it that you cry? Why is it that you cry?" And he said to the Prophet, he said to his son, he said, "Oh my son," he said, "there were three stages in my life. He said, the first stage was, there was no man more hated to me in my sight than Muhammad. I wanted to kill him. I was plotting, I was planning against him day and night. That was my life. I went to the Abyssinians, I went to the Persians, I went to the Romans, plotting and planning against Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." And he said, "then Allah opened up my heart and I started knowing and learning about Al-Islam. And then what happened, one day I went to the Prophet. I went to the Prophet and I said, oh Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, I want to become Muslim." And the Prophet alayhi salam opened up his hand and he said, "oh Am," he said, put your hand in my hand." And Amr ibn al-As, he put his hand forward and he pushed it back, he pulled it back again. And the Prophet smiled and he said, "oh Am," he said, "what is this?" And he said, "Ya Rasulullah," he said, "you know I have done more than enough. I have conspired against you." He said, "you know what I've done towards the Muslims." He said, "my blood is halal, you know that. Give me what?" He said, "give me protection. Tell me that if I become Muslim, my life will be spared." And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "oh Amr," he said, "don't you know three things, expel everything before it." He said, "the Shahada," to say, "ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah," to say, "I bear witness that there's no one to be obeyed, followed or worshipped other than Allah. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger of Allah." To say that expiates everything before it. And he said, "hijrah, feast for the sake of Allah, to migrate for the sake of Allah." Not to say, okay, I'm migrating to Dubai because I love it more there, so I'm making hijrah. Many people, they've got this concept. Rather, hijrah for the sake of Allah, where you can practice your deen better than the present place that you're living in. He said, "hijrah, for the sake of Allah, erases everything before it." And he said, "well, hajj erases everything before it." So this was the case of Amr ibn al-As. And he said, "the third stage of my life," he said, "there's no man more revered to me in my sight." He said, "I did not have," when once he started living by the Sharia and understanding the Sharia, he said, "if you were to ask me to describe Muhammad," he said, "I could not have described him. I would not be able to describe the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." The Sahaba were such that they, after they understood the Sharia and they understood that he was the messenger of Allah, some of them, like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, some of the main companions, they said, "if you were to ask me to describe Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I would not be able to do so." That was the humility they had in front of the Prophet. So my dear brothers and sisters, the brother, he's repented for what he's done in the past. And inshallah, he wants to come in to the fold of Al-Islam, revert back to the true way of life. And inshallah, he's apologized to the people. Also, he's written letters to the courts and so on. He wants to take back his statements, what he said previously, I believe. That's the case. And inshallah, he wants his shahada to be witnessed by all of us here today. And inshallah, I'm gonna take his shahada, inshallah, hold back on the fireworks. Inshallah, the brother, I'm gonna basically take his repeat. I'm sure he's done it before, but inshallah, for the benefit of the viewers and also for the witnesses, inshallah, repeat after me. Ashhadu.
Ashhadu.
Allah ilaha.
Allah ilaha.
Ha.
Ha.
Illallahu.
Illallahu.
Wa ashhadu.
Wa ashhadu.
Anna.
Anna.
Muhammad.
Muhammad.
Abduhu.
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 Wa rasuluhu.
Wa rasuluhu.
I'll repeat what I just said in English. You said, for example, many times we hear the concept where people say, "there is no God but God," or "no table but table." That doesn't make sense for us. Or rather, we say that there is no one to be obeyed, there is no one to be followed, no one to be worshipped other than Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we believe and we testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger of Allah. That this is what you've said.
Yes.
And you believe in that.
Yes.
With conviction, inshallah.
Allah!
Alhamdulillah. The brother Umar, Hamza, Jenvy, inshallah. Well, he's become part of the global brotherhood of 1 billion point wherever, I don't know. Alhamdulillah, inshallah. May Allah guide the brother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us.